Mr. Obama, if you don't get the nomination, will it be because of racism? Obama, no. It will be because I've not articulated a vision that the American people can embrace. And I said to myself, he had every opportunity to talk about race and racism. He didn't do it. This is a new guy, a new kind of black Democrat. Thank God. But he turned out to be the old kind of black Democrat, the kind who plays a race card in order to generate anger on the part of minorities to get those votes. And you think I'm being unfair? Debbie Wasserman Schultz is his hand-picked chair of the DNC. The Republicans have launched a war on blacks, a war on minorities. They want to turn back the clocks to the Civil War era. Said it over and over again. Did Obama say anything about it? Of course not. He encouraged it. Claire McCaskill is a senator in Missouri. And when she ran, she's on her second term now, when she ran, she said that George W. Bush let people die on rooftops during Hurricane Katrina because they were poor, because they were black. She said that. Now, what do you think that does to the sensibilities of people living in her state about race and race relations when it comes to the police? You have the President of the United States being accused of racism, being accused of letting people die. And when she was on Tim Russert, to his credit, the late Tim Russert said, you said that. Do you believe it? No, I don't. Then why'd you say it? Well, because people there believe it. But do you believe it? No, I don't. Then why did you say it? Well, maybe I shouldn't have. Why'd you do it? Well, you know why you did it. They don't say N-word or S-word anymore, said Charlie Rangel. They just say, let's cut taxes. Howard Dean once called the Republican Party the white party. You guys are always slinging the race card around, and then you're surprised when something like this happens and people go berserk because you've taught them that there's inherent, pernicious, indigenous, systematic racism. It'll never go away. It's always there. The fact that Obama won doesn't mean a damn thing. And now you're shocked that black people are in arms over something about which they ought not be in arms over. And then you give them lectures on how to be calm. Who made them like this? Who made them think like victocrats? You guys did. How about telling Sharpton to shut up? Made his bones lying about Tawana Brawley. Right in the center of what Jewish leader in New York called the most serious pogrom in the history of the American Republic, the Crown Heights affair. Sharpton's right in the thick of that. If the Jews want to get it on, tell them to pin their yarmulke and come over to my house. They got him on a videotape discussing a cocaine deal with an undercover Fed guy. He's almost $5 million light in payroll and state and federal taxes. And there he is in the thick of this thing. Are you kidding me? Ugh. Charlie Rangel. They don't say N-word or S-word anymore. They just say, let's cut taxes. The smiling analyst on CNN, Donna Brazile, referred to the Republican Party as having a white boy attitude. Howard Dean once called the Republican Party the white party. I could go on and on and on and on. How dare they act like this is 1965 Selma instead of 2014? How do you do that? How do you do that? Why do you do that? And if Sharpton does not look like a buffoon, I don't know who does. This man is $4.7 million light in taxes. Nobody says a word about it. Can you imagine if I were $4.7 million light in taxes? Rush Limbaugh, 4.7, Sean Hannity? Are you kidding me? And he's on a surveillance tape 30 years ago discussing a cocaine deal with an agent he met apparently three times, according to an article I recently read in a London paper called the Daily Mail. Came out a few months ago. And they interviewed the guy who said that Sharpton met with an undercover agent three times to do a cocaine deal in the 80s because he needed the money. Now, if that were on my resume, it wouldn't be brought up. Oh, that's 30 years ago. I'm not going to bring up Larry's cocaine. Are you kidding me? Right in the thick of Crown Heights, stirring it up, fomenting a riot between blacks and Jews. If the Jews want to pin their yarmulke and come over to my house and get it on, let them do it, said Sharpton. And he's got a show on NBC? Are you kidding me? Martin Bashir gone. Alec Baldwin gone. This guy goes down to Ferguson stirring everything up. Duke Lacrosse turned out to be fraudulent. He's in the thick of that. He's still got a gig. He's still got a job. Unbelievable. While talking about racism. If racism is holding black people back, how does somebody like that, $4.7 million light in taxes, lied his way into fame with Tawana Brawley, falsely accused a man of raping her, was found unanimously liable by a multi-ethnic jury, took him years to pay off his money, only paid it off because his rich buddies passed the hat and paid it off because he's running for president. In the thick of the Crown Heights, we haven't even talked about Freddie's Fashion Mart or the people that he brought down to the courthouse during the trial of the people that were accused of raping the Central Park jogger, many of these people were saying, the boyfriend did it, the boyfriend did it. These were sharpness homies that he brought down there. How does somebody ignore all that and give this man a gig on a network show, cable show, hour-long every night? How does that happen? And Martin Bashir makes a comment about defecation on Sarah Palin, and he's gone. It's mind-blowing.